So you just started streaming to Kick utilizing Streamlabs. Now you want to go ahead and add your Kick chat and your Kick chat overlay. The only problem is that Streamlabs isn't integrated with Kick just yet. So we kind of have to be a ninja about setting this up. So it's super important that you follow this video step by step. Otherwise, you're going to run into problems and it's not going to work the way that you want. So you want to go ahead and have your Streamlabs open. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get connected over to Twitch. This is the first ninja hack to be able to go ahead and get it connected to Kick. So here on the bottom left, you're going to select login. You're going to log in with your Twitch account and it's going to ask you to go ahead and authorize. Once you've done that, we can come back here to Streamlabs and that's going to give us some additional tools that we need to be able to go ahead and get the Kick chat connected. On the left hand side, you're going to see editor. You'll select that. You'll select layout editor. And then here you want to make sure you're on the top right editor. It's going to give you here this left side website. So for the first thing on the website, we need to go ahead and type in Kick. This is extremely important. If you do not do this step, you will not be able to comment inside of your chat inside of Streamlabs. You'll only be able to view the message. Super important that you do this. And you know that it worked because you'll see the Kick website. Now, very important, you want to select accept on the cookies. This is going to allow us to be able to do what we need to do. Then you want to come up to the top and get logged in with your Kick account. So go ahead and do that now. Then once you've gone ahead and gotten logged in, we want to come back to the layout editor. And what we want to do is now we want to delete this link here and we want to go ahead and use our chat. So to be able to get our chat link, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to come to your Kick channel. You want to come to your creator dashboard. And then here on the bottom right, you want to hit this little gear icon. And you want to go ahead and hit select pop out chat right here. And then once you select the pop out chat, you want to go ahead and copy the URL that we have here at the top, kick.com/lastcurry/chatroom. And of course, that will be your username in the center there. So once you have that, we'll come back into Streamlabs and we'll paste that in there. We'll select save changes. And now you can see here that we have our chat. Now, if you did not do the first step, you would not be able to go ahead and type in your chat directly inside of Streamlabs. That's why I said it's super important that you do that first. Now that we have our chat directly inside of Streamlabs, we now want to go ahead and make sure that we're able to add our chat directly into our gameplay scene or our just chatting scene. That way our chat can see it as well. Otherwise, we're not going to be able to go ahead and do this. So to be able to go ahead and get that chat overlay, we want to go ahead and come over to a tool called Botrix.live. And I'll put a link in the description of this video. Now, again, you're going to see the problem here is that you can't get logged in with Kick just yet, but we are going to do the ninja hack to be able to get this possible. So again, we'll go ahead and get logged in with our Twitch account. That's going to go ahead and ask us to go ahead and provide authorization. Once you've done that, you can disregard the Botrix Premium. We don't need it. And now you're going to see here that we have the option to be able to get signed in with our Kick. So this is what we're going to need to do. We'll go ahead and get signed in. We'll go ahead and type in our username. We'll simply select accept. And now it's going to give us the option to say, please give the moderator role to Botrix to continue. So we'll go ahead and hit continue. That's going to bring us back over to our Kick channel. And we're going to see here, it's going to say channel moderators. We want to hit add new. And all we want to do is search Botrix. You'll see it'll come up with the check mark. That's the one you want to select. You'll select add. And then here it's going to say Botrix has been added to the moderator list. Perfect. Now we can come back. And now it says go to kick.com/Botrix and paste the following command. So what we'll do is that we'll copy this and then we'll click that link. It's going to bring us here to our chat. And then what we want to do is you want to just paste that, hit send. And now once you've done that, you'll see here that it says your account has been successfully linked. So now that we've done that, we can select finish. And now you'll see here that we have our Kick connected. Now, if you do not do this step right here, you will not be able to go ahead and get access to your chat overlay. You need to select settings to make sure that you have Kick selected when we go ahead and do this. So now that we have that in place, we're going to come here to where it says widgets. We're going to look for the one that says chat. And then now we'll see here that we have our chat preview. So you can turn off Trovo, you can turn off Twitch, you can turn off YouTube. We just want to go ahead and utilize the Kick chat. Now you can go ahead and set hide bot messages, which I do recommend. You do want to go ahead and have the emotes to be able to utilize. Hide old messages, I go ahead and disable this. And then as far as the design goes, I prefer to utilize bubbles. So once you have that in place, you're going to see here that the chat's going to pop up. We're going to want to come to where it says widget URL and select copy. Then you want to come back here into Streamlabs and you want to come to the scene where we want to add that chat. So I'm going to do it first here on my Just Chatting. I'm going to click this little plus sign under sources. And then I'm going to go ahead and select browser source. I'm going to go ahead and hit add source. I'm then going to go ahead and name this Kick chat. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit add source. And now in the URL section, this is where we want to go ahead and paste the link that we just went ahead and copied from Botrix. So once you have that in place, it's going to be there. And we want to go ahead and select close. Now you're going to see here that we have our chat. So what we want to do is we want to drag it and we want to place it in the spot where we're going to want to utilize it. And then here on the left-hand side, you're going to be able to do a test, and then it's going to go ahead and pop up here for us to be able to go ahead and view. As you can see there, we have test. Now, one thing that you can do is that you can hold the Alt or the Shift key to be able to adjust it. And then you're able to place the chat directly inside of the box where you want it to be able to go ahead and live. If you want to go ahead and add the chat overlay to any other section of your stream, you don't need to copy that link once again. So if I come here into my gameplay scene, I can now go ahead and add that chat overlay there as well by clicking this plus icon, selecting browser source, selecting add source, and then you'll see here that we have an existing browser source. We'll hit add source, and now you can see here that our chat is now here as well, and you'll see the chat start to pop up. Now, the only problem that you're going to have is that if somebody decides to go ahead and do long characters, like just typing A-A-A-A-A-A-A-A all the way through, let me show you that example, it's going to go ahead and get cut off. So we need to go ahead and add a custom link to be able to make sure that that does not happen. So if I were to do that to be able to fix this, and I'm going to put this in the description of the video as well, what you need to be able to do. But what we want to do is we want to come to our browser source. We want to hit this little gear icon, and you want to make sure that here where it says custom CSS, you paste in that code that I went ahead and shared. And that's going to make sure that if somebody goes ahead and types in long characters, AAA or long paragraphs, it's not going to get cut off. It's going to go into a second line to make sure that your chat stays super clean. But there is one more thing that you can do to make your stream look professional, and that's watching this video where I show you step by step how to add animated overlays to your Kick streams utilizing Streamlabs. Click that video right there. See you guys in the next video.